Hi there. Many of you don't know who I am. My name is Dan Rivera. Most of my friends back at Azusa know me as Danny. And I've got a lot of great stories about Paul this morning. I'd like to share with you, Paul and I grew up together. We were buddies. Paul and I met probably in the fourth grade, Dalton School. We grew up together and went to school together. A lot of the things I heard about Paul this afternoon have been where he was great in design and art, or he took a liking to cars. I'd like to share with you maybe a story or two about him that I think were the seeds that got him to where he is today, and a lot of those things that you talked about this morning. When we grew up, we went to school together. We lived about 100 yards away from each other. He lived on the street, Eaton, and I lived on Orange Street. While we went to school, we took a liking to each other because we met at Northside Park. And we had the love of baseball. He and I used to play baseball for hours at that park. And we became buddies. We would always have our mitts together. He would have his bat, and I would have the baseballs. My uncle worked as a janitor at some of the elementary schools, and he came across all the baseballs. So I had a bucket full of them, and Paul needed them. So we became buds. I met his mom, and as we became buddies, I had an opportunity to meet Eloise, and she was like a second mother to me. She really had a positive influence on my life. Took me in, would feed me from time to time before we went to school. One little story I'll tell you about. My mother invited Paul over for dinner. And as a Mexican family, you might imagine, my mother introduced him to carne asada, rice and beans, and homemade tortillas. Eloise introduced me to oatmeal with cinnamon and raisins. I think Paul got the better of the deal. And we became buds, and we played baseball together. We joined Little League together. We were on separate teams. Paul was a stud. He really could play baseball very, very well. And I was not as good as Paul. In fact, Paul was hitting very, very well. I wasn't. So Eloise, we were playing against each other one afternoon, and Eloise was sitting there at the table while we're waiting before we're going. And Paul knew I was struggling. So Paul said, I got an idea. He said, what I'm going to do, because I'm pitching today. Now, Paul was an awesome pitcher. He could throw fastballs, and that's why he was so highly sought after. So he said, you know what I'm going to do? I am going to throw the ball at not full speed, but just like we used to do at Northside Park. And I'm going to throw it so that you can hit it. You talk about relationships that I heard this morning and doing for others without even thinking about himself. He said, I'm going to do this. So Eloise got behind it and said, hey, that's a great idea. So there I am. We're at a baseball game. And I was afraid that he wasn't going to follow through. And so as the story goes on, he threw my loop plate. And I swung at him and missed him. I had two strikes on me, and Paul knew that I was going to swing, so what did Paul do? He threw the ball on the ground, as if it was a bad pitch. Yeah, I ended up walking to the base. I didn't strike out, but he threw the ball either over my head, around the plate, or on the ground, and I got to first base. As he went to the mound, and as I got to first base, he looked over at me, and I looked at him, and he kind of gave me that little wink of an eye. And I thought, you know, what better friend could you have? As we grew older, Paul and I used to get in a lot of mischief. as young kids. I remember that there were times when he and I would sit in his back room. They had a garage, and they had his room that was off to the side. And we would go out there and spend hours just talking about things, listening to albums like The Doors. He wanted to listen to The Doors all day long. But while we were doing that, he was constantly drawing. He was always drawing something on a piece of paper, doing some sort of etch. When we went to Northside Park, they used to have competition of these wooden racers. And Harry bought Paul and I a box where you had to design, shape the racers so that as they go down the steep, they would have first place, second place, and they'd go on and on. Harry helped us design them. And my dad helped us cheat. My dad drilled a hole in the face of the racer and put metal into it to give it a little more speed as it went down. And Paul thought that was the greatest idea in the world. So there we are. My dad drills the hole in the front. We put a piece of metal in it. And then we put putty over it and we painted it. Paul and I came in first and second in Princess California Zoo, though, for the recreation. So nobody knew how we did it. We used to get in trouble a lot. We would we'd go up to Northside Park, and at the time they built the Azusa golf course. And we would sit there and we said, what do you want to do? And we'd go up to Northside Park, and the golf course was right adjacent to it. And as the golfers would come around, they would hit the golf ball, and they couldn't see it because it was kind of a blind alley. We'd go out there and steal the golf balls and come back. As we got older, we graduated from Salson High School. We went into high school, Azusa High. And I can remember Paul and I still being best buddies. He started driving. I always taught him how to drive on that old mercury bomb he had. It was a three on the column. And as he started to learn how to drive, he would constantly grind the gears, and Harry would yell out, you gotta take your foot off that car, off the clutch. He took a liking to, we double dated, my wife Cheryl was back there. We double dated with Paul, and we would go to Irwindale Raceway. And he had a fascination about going to those raceways and watching those cars jet around. I'd like to think that's where he started his love for cars. Because the older the car, the more in tune he was with it. But he loved that Mercury. It was the bomb. It was the car that you saw him drive around in that car, you knew it was Paul Stemrich. And anybody that was in that car was a friend of his. We double dated a lot with him. We both graduated from Azusa High. He went on his way, and I went on mine. For years, we lost a little touch. And then recently, I'd say maybe 5 years ago, I picked up the phone and called. And it was like we never lost touch with each other. He talked about his family and the love that he had for his children and for his grandchildren. And what a blessed life he had. He may not have been the wealthiest man in the world, but as I heard this morning, I reflect upon Paul. He was wealthier than one could imagine with the love of his friends and the love of his family. I want to read something to you so that you bear with me. I had something special hit me. And this was on Christmas Day. It was 11:54 and I text Paul and I said, hey bud, Merry Christmas to you and your family. very grateful for the long-term friendship and want you to know that many times I reflect on our time together. School, sports, double dating, and much more. Stay well and know that you are my favorite friend, Danny. On Thursday, the 26th, Paul responded, "Thanks, Danny, for that friendship note. I feel the same way about you. You made my Christmas. Love, always your buddy, Paul." That
focuses
my buddy. I never had a buddy like that before. Probably never will. But I'm so grateful for the time I got to spend with him for 18 solid years, having been in school together, and all the memories we had together, and all the little mischief we got in together. I had to come here today. I live in Sun City, West Arizona, and I asked my wife, I just got to come to spend time with family and friends, and to share with you the love I had for that boy. I really loved Paul. He was my buddy. Thank you.